Howdy guys, it's Commander Clyde, and we're back. And today we're doing a tier list. That's right, folks, we got our first Season 4 dual tier list going up live for you folks right now. And Smite Guru updated their website, so the link for my tier list no longer works, and it's been inadvertently deleted. So, we're going to completely remake the whole thing. Sounds fun, right? Alright, get into this. We know Season 4 is really screwy, so... yeah, some of these placements are going to be interesting. But it shouldn't be too different from last season. We're going to go in alphabetical order because it's simple. Ogni, he's your basic balance god, so he goes to A like he always is. Muzenkov, really strong, as usual, goes in S+. I don't need to say why. He's got annoying slows and auto attacks that do a lot of damage, and he can do them very quickly. The buff from his hive is insane. We all know that. Opwash, getting a little love. He's not so terrible because of the item changes, but C is as high as he goes because, again, he has problems with killing his opponent. His damage is very situational and it's hard to confirm. And his mobility is really bad. Because the ultimate does not do a whole lot to deter aggression. It's just not that damaging. Amaterasu, because she's auto-attacking warrior, mainly auto-attacking. Gonna put her at A+. Auto attackers are always strong. And on her, going into S+. Swap those two. On her, we know he's strong. He's got a CC immune ultimate. He's got that nasty impale. And that pillar that gives him a buff. So, that gives him a damage buff. And he's all around one of the best hunters, so he goes to S+. Anubis, again, basic balance mage, goes to A. Good control, good damage. Struggles against several different types of gods, however. Alquan goes to A because he consistently does not perform well in duel. Despite his usefulness in conquest as a jungler, you simply cannot do the same things you can in conquest that you in duel that you can in conquest. So he goes there. Aphro, I'm actually liking a lot this season, again, because item changes have made mages and guardians, made magicals in general a lot stronger against physicals, and I feel like Aphrodite has always had good control, and her damage is very good when you have your items online. I feel like she'll be better this season. Apollo, S+. Don't need to talk about that. He's extremely strong right now because of this toll. It makes his audacity that much more useful. Because he's going to heal so much from the death toll. Arachne, feeling good about. Auto-attacking assassins look good right now, too. Give her some extra love and put her at S-. She's got high control, high DPS. All great things, and you can do some nice tower aggro tricks with the spiders. Always good. Ares, we know how terrible he is. So, D. I don't even need to talk about that. Artemis, going to S. She's a hunter, so she gets a little bit of extra love, but she's one of the worst hunters because her mobility is terrible. Too easy to counter her ultimate. You know. And so her DPS is not that high compared to other hunters. For whatever reason, her inhands just don't seem that strong unless you get a crit. Which, as we know, crit is not that valuable in duel. Because it's too easy to counter. Every hunter, most of the other hunters are better than her, and she loses some other lower tiered matchups because of her mobility. Thena goes to A-, because she has surprisingly high damage from her 3, despite not having ultimate. Taunts are always good. She can do some really good things in certain situations. She goes there. A Wheelix I've always liked because of her high damage output. Her mobility is good. The fact that you can immune damage if you time her 2 correctly is also very useful. So I feel she performs pretty well. Bacchus goes to... B, I'm going to say. His damage is really high. We all know that. High burst. All Garden's always useful. His one drawback is his belly flop. If you miss, you're in trouble. So it goes there. Bakasura. Usual OP self. Goes to the top end of S. The reason I don't value him as an S plus is most other hunters can beat him when it's played correctly. On her and Apollo particularly counter him very strongly, so he goes to S because it's hard for him to overwhelm the top tier gods, but he can fight pretty much anything below S. Best hit, I'm seeing an A right now because her late game damage is questionable. At times, if your opponent gets defense early, it's very hard for her to fight into that. She also gets countered by several of the hunters because they can either hit through her cats with an ability and kill them quickly and deal damage to her at the same time, or they have self-peel like Apollo does, and it's very hard for her to combat late game gods. Bellona usually is A plus for me. Why would it not let me put her in the front? Okay, hold on. I gotta... Whatever. It doesn't matter. The hierarchy's fine. Bellona, she's S minus. What am I doing? She's always been great in duel. High DPS, high defense. Her ultimate's really useful for getting her out of bad situations and engaging. And she's just all around a great auto attacking warrior that can hold her own against most gods. There's a few that counter her because they can stop her bludgeon, but for the most part, she's pretty strong. Kabrakin goes to B, where I usually have him. He has very high burst. His control is okay. It's not the greatest, but it works. The main thing is he's got that high burst combo that also stuns you, and that's a very powerful thing to have, especially with items like I forget the name of the scroll, but the one that, you know, does the 10% of your opponent's health as extra damage when you hit an ability every 10 seconds, which makes it better than Soul Reaver. Oh, Ethereal Staff, that's the name of it. Gosh, I'm dumb. Kamazotz, high burst assassin, extremely high burst assassin. He can control. His damage is very frightening, especially early. It's very easy for him to 100 to 0 you. That slow on his 2 is very strong. It's great for chase, because you can pop that, jump right up into your ultimate, and they'll have a very hard time getting away from the damage and from you. Great chase potential. His sustain is enormous. Oh, I just find him very strong ability assassin. Chalk, my main man, he's my dude. Now, you guys know I have a reputation with him, or not a reputation, necessarily, but you guys are aware of the fact that I can win several poor matchups with Chog just because of my individual skill. But as a practical choice, he's A+. He's not. For me, he's probably in on the back end of S plus because of how I can play him, but that's specific to me. We're talking about just a level playing field. And in terms of that, he's an A plus god. As we know, very extremely high burst, extremely high sustain. He's very tanky, he's very hard to kill. Ultimate is a great control tool for stopping your opponent from getting away from you. His 3 has a crazy slow on it, so, you know, he's good god. Chang'e is A+, also high control. She has high sustained damage over time. It's very annoying for her popping her 1 every 3 seconds and her 3 and her heal about every 5 seconds. It's very annoying. It's a lot of damage to continually deal with. And she's very good at wearing her opponents down and then coming in to secure the kill with the ultimate. Her 2 gives her damage immunity, so immunity to everything, actually. So that's really good. Always like that. Chiron. He's going to be getting some buffs soon. So I think I'm going to place him based on that, because there's not that many gods. There's like 4 god changes for the next patch or something. It's not very significant. Chiron's going to get a boost because his 3 is going to have a damage steroid. And they're increasing. Yeah, they increase his damage on his ultimate shots too. I think he cracks S minus this time. Actually, I should put him on par with Artemis, because while technically I think she's probably better than him, Chiron does not have the mobility issue. So it puts them about on par with each other. I think he'll be a better... I still don't think he'll be S plus level. He's always been out-damaged by the hunters in S plus. Like, I had a game against Anuler with Chiron, and he, even though I was had fights where I boxed him better, he just killed me because his damage was just higher at all times. And that's Chiron's downfall. Kronos, they have killed this god. Why is that? Because they took the Fatalis effect off of Accelerate, and that was the one unique thing about him that was cool and was extremely useful. He is terrible now. Well, terrible in the sense that he no longer has that strong status he once did. And now they're trying to justify this by giving him some damage buffs in a couple of areas, like the steroid from his 4th quadrant of Accelerate on his basic attacks, and Time Rift is getting a slight buff. But those changes are not going to help him, and they should have never taken the Fatalis effect off, and he would have been fine. They should have just left him alone. But they didn't, and so he goes to S. Not a big drop, but that Fatalis effect makes a huge difference. Because now if you want the same thing, you have to actually build Fatalis, but Kronos is very dependent on having damage items. And when you take that away from him, it's a lot more difficult, especially in duel where you're going to have at least 1 defensive item. It doesn't work the same as it does with Freya. You can get away with that with her. But her Impulse and Irradiate being active at the same time does more damage than the 4th quadrant on Kronos' Accelerate does. So it's much more difficult for him to keep his damage up than it is for Freya. Cupid goes to S. Good hunter, good mobility, good control. He's got 2 stuns. Though his heart bomb stun is situational, it's still there, and his ult obviously stuns. It's very effective. Big AoE. And he can heal himself, so he's a good balance hunter. Erlon Chin, I put in a similar position as Bellona right now. Yes, he's not as good as he once was. That Death Toll buff, though, is very strong on him because now his cleave heals him for 8 health and 3 mana instead of 6 health and 2 mana as it previously did, which means if he cleaves all three, cleaves three minions at once, he gets 24 health and 9 mana. It's a lot of sustain, and he will overwhelm you because of that sustain in certain matchups. Now, most hunters will still beat him just because they can control him much easier. Overall, he's looking pretty strong right now. Fafnir goes to B. His burst is okay. It's not as good as like Bacchus or Kabrakan, but it's good damage over time. His ultimate's very useful. He can chase well because he can jump at you during the ult and stun you, and then do poison damage. All that things are very good. His late game is not very good, just because his damage output falls off pretty strongly late game. And that's gonna put him down to B. Okay, Fenrir. All right, I feel like he's about the same as Bastet. He has good early damage and all those good things. You know, he can grab people with his ult, put him into tower range. All those things. His late game damage falls off though, and he's also easily controlled by most hunters. Freya is, in my opinion, legitimately SS at this point. The items they have put into the game for mages are going to make her insanely strong. Like the passive on Talkind's Ring, that's just nuts what they've done, and it's going to make her crazy strong. So basically, the idea is if you're playing ranked duel, you ban her. Do not even second guess that. She's really strong right now. Possibly way too strong. I mean, really, certain gods have been SS at certain times, but the point is there should not be a god in the game that is at that level because it's unfair and ridiculous. Geb, I'm gonna put him in C. He does okay damage, but he's just not as good as most of the other guardians. His late game is rough. I mean, if you can avoid like being stunned by him, then you can basically win. And there's not a whole lot you can do. Guan Yu has never been good in duel, really. I mean, based on how he performs, honestly, I would put him in A minus just because he's just not good in duel. He has a very hard time getting his damage off. And most of the time, you can just avoid Talu Assault. Just don't get near him or use an ability to get away, whatever. His late game damage just isn't there where it needs to be. His heal can be countered easily, and it's not a significant heal. It's not significant sustain like, for example, Chalk has. And his ultimate, very easy to deal with. Just get some beads, whatever. All around, he's just not very good. Hades is balanced. In my opinion, he usually is about right there at the point of balance. He has good damage, decent control. Fear is useful in certain matchups, but he does not outperform. He's very easily beaten by certain gods. He's balanced. Hobwa, S+. He's going to have really high damage right now because, again, of the item changes we have mentioned. Makes him even stronger than he already was, but he's not to a broken level. Because his damage is burst, it's not sustained over time, even though he's got very short cooldown. But his main form of damage, his ultimate, can be countered. It can be easily controlled by certain hunters if you know how to play the matchup. So he goes to S+. Hell. Performing slightly better, but still not very good. Too easy to counter her heal. Gonna put her at A-. She's just not... She's never been that great in duels. She gets beaten by several different things. You can avoid her damage most of the time. So, yeah. And the fact that Ankh, and by the way, I noticed something. If you guys might be aware, Chalk's ultimate would cleanse most item effects, including anti-heal from weakening from curse. Ankh does not do that. It will remain. The anti-heal will continue despite any measures you try to put against it. It will still function. And I don't remember if Hell could cleanse that or not. Also, I'm not aware. I feel like she did. That may not be correct, but she's not good. Hercules. High damage, high sustain, but I feel like he's A because he's easier to control. He's got two main abilities that really do anything. His Earthshaker and the one and Driving Strike, which if you miss, if you don't hit the full combo, it's rough out there. And if his abilities are down, he's basically a sitting duck. Having short cooldowns is not as useful for him. Because his abilities don't have that much utility. So, goes to A. He's like a not as good Chalk, basically. Hu Yi, S+. He's pretty strong right now. Gotta remember that Silver Branch bow. That thing is dangerous. Really strong against mages, obviously. But you can also use that at any time, because if you hit 3 autos, it's 45 power, so... So it can be a great early bridge item, which has made all the hunters stronger. Hu Yi is just inherently good because he does extra damage because of his Mark the Golden Crow. He's got a stun. He's got a slow. He can jump on you, so you know, he's a good hunter all around. Hunbots is an A+ for me. He's got high damage with short cooldown, good burst with short cooldowns. His ultimate is a great ultimate, high control. You can push your enemies back towards you and then do more damage. You can also combo it with certain relics to make it even more effective. All around, he's a good ability assassin. Isis, I've always felt like, is just balanced. As usual. Actually, I think she's a little better this season, so I'm going to put her at A+ instead. Same thing. Her wave clear is really good. She's got good control. She can stun you with the Spirit Ball, which has a fairly short cooldown. That into the Wing Ghost is very strong. Her ultimate is good. High burst, high healing if you use it on yourself. You can also lock your opponents in it with the Spirit Ball. All around, she's a pretty good mage. Izanami, she has a mobility problem. And for that, we put her in S with the other hunters that either are just not as good or have mobility issues. She goes there. Her damage is good. She's got the slow on her too. Her one can be potent when used at the right time. Her ult is very good because of the silence and the high damage it does. Her stealth can be used in some really interesting ways to sneak up on your opponent. That's especially useful early before the minions have spawned. But you're probably not going to have it at that point. Like, you could go into stealth, come over to someone's buff when they're there, and surprise them. It can be really effective. Janus, A, because he doesn't have any... Because he doesn't have a stun, he's usually not as good as the mages that do have stuns. Because it makes its damage harder to secure, things like that. Portals are always great for getting away and chasing, though. His wave clear is really good. He's pretty balanced in duel. That's in duel, by the way. In Conquest, he's broken, but there's some specific reasons for that, which I will not get into here, because this is a duel tier list, and we'll be here forever. Jingwei, S+. Passive is broken in duel, because she can get back to lane so quick. Her explosive bolts are strong, as usual. Her gust is strong if you hit your opponent, and then you can, like, fly at them and just DPS them like crazy. It's also good to apply the passive to yourself to get more attack speed. Her ult can get her in and out of danger really easily. And can be a great chase tool. Overall, she's a good hunter. And about in the same spot as most of the other top hunters. Kali, S+, because she's Kali. High DPS. She can chase you really well. Her ultimate is a very useful tool for diving. Things like that. Great to keep yourself alive if you need the extra time to secure a kill. Great burst, actually, if you hit the stun and lash combo, or whatever it's called. Whatever, the sickles, you know what those are. Yeah, she's always been a very strong god in duel, and will continue to be so. Kepri is not worth talking about. He's terrible for reasons I don't even need to explain. Kukulkan is A, balanced, good damage, good wave clear, has a mobility issue, though, that keeps him in that balanced spot. Put him right there. Kumbhakarna is also a B guardian. He's got high damage. If you can secure everything, some of his abilities can be hard to hit. His one can be hard to hit because of the travel time. Things like that. His mez is really strong in certain situations. The ult is a very strong ability. High damage can set up other things. Root is always good because that's more control, more CC, more damage secure, all that. Of course, with every Guardian, damage falls off late. Abilities have fairly long cooldowns, so it makes him easy to counter late game. Loki, S-. There's a lot of, you know, those Reddit people who think he's really awesome and cool, but Loki mains are nasty, and that, and the god is disgusting if you play him, but thinking about it, his wave clear is okay. Takes a few levels for it to actually get to full clearing. The wave is hard, but that stealth is really strong. He has extremely high burst damage. He can run around the map and you'll never see him because of his stealth and his mobility. He can proxy waves easily. It's extremely annoying, but again, countered by some of the higher tier hunters. Any type of crowd control on him will basically will destroy him. He does not handle crowd control very well. Medusa is a lot stronger now. I'm actually going to put her in S+. Mobility is really good. Right now, some of the item changes have benefited her greatly. She has high damage, so I'm feeling like she's a lot better this season, going to S+. Mercury is S-. The slow immunity from his 2 that they added is a really good feature. He's got some good items this season he can use. Having Wind Demon and Poison Star give attack speed are good because he can build into those items pretty well. High Burst God, he's got 2 good forms of CC from Special Delivery and his ultimate. And he's good at chasing people down, so gonna put him in S-. Naja. Generally, I feel like he's an A, honestly. He hasn't been performing that well lately. There's several different things that counter him and work to his disadvantage. Most of his damage is situational because it relies on you hitting his sash and his ultimate for the most part. If he misses those things, then there's not much he can do. He's very easy to control late game. His cooldowns are pretty long, so he can get controlled easily when his abilities are down. And if you can survive his burst damage, then you usually win. Neith is, I feel like, S-. She just does not perform well in duel for whatever reason. She's got high ability burst, yeah, and a fairly decent amount of control and sustain. Only problem is most other hunters are going to beat her. And I think any of the other gods that I have ahead of her can beat her pretty easily too. Her late game is just not that good for some reason. She falls off. And that's why I gotta put her at S-. Nemesis, feeling the same thing about her. She's got high DPS. She's got 2 slows. And her ultimate strips protections. So she's a good god, good chase potential, all that, but she gets countered by any form of CC because it makes Retribution useless. And she'll get stunned out of it. All that, most of the hunters can beat her because of that. On her and Apollo have always been direct counters to her because of that. And any other guys ahead of her, say Bakasura, can just out DPS her for the most part, so she just loses those matchups automatically because of the stronger DPS other guns have over her. Nike, I'm feeling A+ for her also. She's got good clear and high damage, but it can be interrupted because her one is her main form of damage, which can be interrupted. Jump is good for chase if you can land it. Ult is great control option, gives her a lot of survivability. But late game against any god that can interrupt her one, it's rough for her to fight into. And that's why for the most part, she ends up not being that good in duel. She certainly has her uses. I'm sure good players can do very well with her. But she's about A+. Nox is an A-. Put her in B. She's never been that great because her damage is so hard to secure for the most part. But her clear is really strong. Her damage is high if you can secure it. If you can get the damage off and actually secure it. So, which keeps her from being in B. instead of A minus, but for the most part, she's not that good. So she goes to A minus. Nuwa is an A god. Your basic balance mage, good damage, good control. Her survivability is very poor, though, if you can get in her face and have a way to ignore the minions, especially if you've got a way to ignore her minions, you know, you have something with CC immunity, you can just go past the minions and straight to her. Keeps her balanced. Odin is... I feel like he's back end of A minus. Damage again, situational, it's hard to confirm. But it's good against certain gods when you are able to do that. But for the most part, he's extremely easy to control. And to kill because of that, chase him down. If his two and his jump are down, he's almost useless. So he goes to A minus. Osiris, always like him. I feel like he's an S minus right now. He's kind of in the same spot as Erling Shen. In terms of the Dust Hole being very useful and things like that. And he's an auto attacker, so auto attackers always do well in duel. And he's got a lot of defense because of the natural mitigation he has. Poseidon, A plus for me right now until I see some other stuff from him. The new items again make him pretty strong right now. You can build an auto attack-ish a lot easier on him now because of the variety of those items. It makes tough kinds pretty useful to him. You could actually go for that instead of a spear. You know, at your leisure if you wanted to. Gem of Isolation is still one of his best items. Always very dangerous, very good for control and clear. All around pretty good, but gets beaten by gods that can get up in his face and control him. Ra is balanced. In my opinion, he's got high damage and great wave clear, good, very high sustain. The protections he's got from his heal now that they added, very strong. It makes it a lot harder to actually fight him in the middle of Solar Blessing. Is that what it's called? I think so. And yeah, it makes him a little better than he was. Still has the mobility issues, and his healing can be countered very easily. Raijin is about in the same spot. Raiju can be hard to hit sometimes. Makes his damage slightly harder to confirm. Again, like most of the mages in A, he can be controlled easily if you're able to get within melee range of him. Very hard for him to deal with. I think he's slightly better than like Ra because of his teleport, but only slightly better. Not enough to keep him out of A. Ra, back into S+. He's got a natural attack. He's got an attack speed steroid from his two astral arrows, do bonus damage. If you can hit all of them, it's very strong, does a lot. He can roll at people and cripple and slow them, but he can also roll away from danger just as easily. His ultimate can get him out of trouble and secure long-distance kills. He's always been a pretty good hunter. Gets outperformed by a few of the other hunters, like, you know, AMC on her Apollo or all outperform him usually, but he does pretty well in most other matchups. Ratatasker, S minus. Good control. He's got a knockup and a stun. His damage can be pretty high. He's good at sticking to targets because he can dash at them and slow them. And his full ability combo can do a lot of damage. You can also dive with it very with his ultimate very easily. So, Robin is just bad right now. He's just bad. He's not relevant anymore in Duel. They've just taken a lot out of. They've gutted him quite a bit. And he just straight up cannot fight most gods at close range. He just gets outboxed. Because, you know, it's like, do you go ability based or auto attack? You know, don't know which, but either way, they both fall off late. Both ideas, both forms of damage fall off late game. He's just not good. Scylla, A+, because of her high damage. And she can do a lot quickly. If she can manage to hit a root on you, she can do that. And then ult you right on that spot. Good Scylla players can go to the root from the root right into the ultimate. Do a lot of damage. She can get out of danger pretty easily with her Sentinel. And also provides her vision if she needs it, which is always a useful thing. But her high damage puts her in A+, even though she's got mobility issues and long cooldowns. Sirkette, better this season, looking a lot better. Feel like she can be an S minus. She's got high burst damage, especially if you can connect all your abilities and then hit the big auto to inflict the extra damage from the poison. Her ultimate is great for grabbing a target and pushing it into an area that puts them at a disadvantage. Also stops healing, which is looking to be very useful this season. Scotty is S plus. High damage. Slow is really strong. Calder is a really annoying thing. That also lets her backdoor and other things. You can tank for her and block auto attacks. It's just good when you're in a boxing match. She's got high damage, and when you get attack speed items online, she can DPS you really quick by weaving her abilities in during boxing. Slows are always strong when you're boxing another opponent. Sobek, I want to say, is A minus actually. Pull strong. His combo from, if you hit his 3 and his 2, it does quite a bit of damage. Cooldowns are pretty short on that combo. And it heals him and does also inflicts anti-healing. It's really useful. His ultimate, high burst, slows targets. You can do some quick executes with it. He's got better control and sustained damage than other Guardians, which I think makes him a little bit better than the rest of them. Soul is S plus for, again, items, making the magical carries a lot stronger now. And at Soul, she's got high burst, very high DPS at full heat. She has an ability that gives her immunity to everything. And a burst of movement speed. Her ult can do a lot of damage. Also good if you hit it during fights because it slightly displaces your opponents and that'll keep them from casting abilities. And it's very annoying. Also has good sustain late from her one. Sun Wukong is A. he does things a little bit better than Guan Yu does, because all his abilities are straight up burst. One, you hit your opponent with it once, and it inflicts damage once. The high burst of the tiger stun does a lot of burst damage. Comboing all your abilities together does quite a bit. He gets healing from his ultimate, which you can counter that with a properly used relic, but it can be very hard to time properly. Susanoo, I don't know if I'm feeling him right now, really. You know, he's at the back end of S minus right now. His damage is good, but falls off late. He's always had pretty good control and wave clear. Although most of these gods up here can beat him. Particularly Erlang Shen, for whatever reason, that is just an awful matchup for Susanoo. So he can control everything Susanoo does. And trying to burst a warrior is just hard for him, for Susanoo to do, because of how much his damage falls off late. And if you can, you know, stun him or anything outside of his dash, he's pretty much done for. Hard for him to be useful when his abilities are down, because he's not going to outbox a hunter. Sylvanas is... C, just, his damage isn't that good. He has decent sustain, but that's not enough to make him, to take him from C to B. It's just not there for him. Terra, I gotta have the same reasoning with her. Damage isn't that great. You have to dump your entire kit to kill somebody, and you'll probably have to do that two or three times for it to be a risk to your opponent. Her ult is decent, but it really doesn't help her do much except chase kills, and if you somehow get your opponent low, it's mainly just going to be used defensively. Overall, just not very good. Thanatos, I think, can be at a good spot in A. He's not performing that well, right? Actually, let me put him in A+. He's a little better than that. He's not performing that great right now, but he's just at an average point, really. Turns, but early, he has that really high early burst that's so great on him. His ability combos are always really good. Can do a lot of damage quickly. Death Toll is going to make him slightly better because his third auto is a cleave, more healing. So, overall, I think he's about an A+. The Moor again. She's going to be a little hard to place. But I think, honestly, I haven't seen her use much. You know, I'm going to put her at S-, and we're going to see what happens. I think she's actually deceptively very good. Now, and I'll explain that. Her wave clear can be very good. You know, that third auto is a AoE type of deal, and will inflict extra damage on minions. If you combo somebody with her two, and the one that inflicts the doom, and then you hit stun them with the other ability, that does quite a bit of burst damage. Now her one is her stun, and then her two is the line casted thing that does the doom effect. And she can do it from stealth. You know, she can go into stealth, pop her one, you'll never see her, and she'll stun you. Can be really good for engaging your opponent for an initial engagement. Her ult is extremely useful particularly, that's a very matchup specific kind of thing. But having, but say you're fighting another hunter or something that's got some, you know, that has some other form of CC, like, she can be really good because, you know, you could dump your kit into someone, do a lot of damage, they're still not dead, you pop your ultimate, and it'll probably end up being pretty useful for you to ultimately secure the kill. Which can make her good against hunters, because she'd ordinarily be at a disadvantage, but you can ult at the right time, you know, and actually box the hunter, because you're going to be the same god, basically. And it makes it a lot easier for her to fight into hunters, especially when she can use all her abilities on you, ult, and then use your own abilities against you, and then come back out of it with her other, with her own abilities back off of cooldown, so... Pretty good. Thor underperforms. He's not that great. His damage falls off light very easily, despite his combo being so good. Only advantage is he's going to have his early game, and if you're not ahead by then, you're probably going to lose. Thoth, I feel like he's an A+, just because of his high damage. And safety with being able to clear and do damage. He can do damage from pretty far away with his glyph of pain, and that makes him a lot better than some of the other mages, because he doesn't have to put himself into too much danger to do damage. His ult is ridiculously high damage. All around, he's a pretty good mage. Tyr. Gonna put... I'm going to put him in A-. And he's got that problem of his, if his abilities are down, he's very easy to control and kill. And it's also very easy to stop his abilities from being useful. You know, because he's going to have to dump that Fearless and hit you with that Fearless to get his best combo and damage potential, but you can easily avoid it or get something for CC immunity, which makes that useless. Slows are like a nightmare to him, because he does not have much to get away from them with. For all, he's just, his damage is very hard to put out, isn't good late game, and he's very easy to control. Uller is S+, as usual. He's just a good god because he can do everything. He can do the early ability burst and then transition easily into a pure high DPS character. Which, by the way, is insane because of his steroid from his 2 giving him attack speed and damage. Overall, he's a very strong hunter. He can hold his own against pretty much anything. Vimana, I am liking a lot, because he's Vimana, he's extremely hard to kill, he's got a lot of burst damage, that if you build correctly, honestly doesn't seem to fall off against squishy gods, and he's, again, extremely defensive. He can control enemies really, really well. His ultimate can is really great for objective diving and also killing objectives, because it increases his auto attack damage so much. Overall, I think he's looking pretty good this season. Not obviously to the level of like Erlang Shen or Osiris, but he's in a good spot right now. Vulcan. As we know, he's been really strong lately. New items make him even better. So I feel like he's an S-. Great damage with low cooldowns. So he can hit you a lot with everything. Just his 3 and his 1 does a lot of damage to you. And then, obviously, there's the threat of the ultimate. Xibalanque. S-. because he's a hunter, but he's always underperformed because the only form of control he has is his two. His ultimate is easy enough to deal with. It's not that useful in duel. And he just has a hard time boxing everything because he's got a low in hand. He's got a low attack, starting attack speed. And his mobility isn't that great. He's got his 3, yeah, but it doesn't do a whole lot. And if you time it right, you can actually cancel it with another form of CC, because his CC immunity actually takes a little bit to start during the ability. But mainly, he just underperforms compared to the other hunters, so S minus. Xingqian, you guys know I like this guy. But justifiably, I have to put him in A minus because he's a guardian. His late game, his damage falls off late game. But Xingqian in particular has a lot of burst for a guardian. His cooldowns are pretty short for the most part. That ultimate does a lot of damage if you can hit it, but he really doesn't need it to kill anybody. His other 3 abilities do a lot. And again, new items are insane on him. You guys have already seen that from me showing him in the solo lane on PTS. Certain items are just broken on him. Ymir, I like in the same spot too, because of his high control and burst that he can do so quick and often. Makes him a nightmare to deal with if you're low mobility or don't have a wave or don't have any CC immunity. In type, his burst is very surprisingly high and he can kill you very quickly if you're not paying attention. Zeus, we're looking at mobility issues on him. He's always had those problems. I think A minus is about where I had him before. His damage can be blocked, you know, with a well-timed Aegis. Stops his detonate damage, which is the best part about him. It can be hard to confirm your chain lightning and chain it across targets to do more damage to your opponent. And if you get up in his face, you're probably going to be able to kill him because there's not much he can do to get away from you. And then finally, Zhongkui. That's correct. Goes to A. Again, items are going to make him better this season, but he still has mobility issues and his ultimate damage very easy to counter because it's sustained over time. If you get a shell, it's like over, because he just will not be able to kill you late game. And alright, guys, that's going to do it. An hour long tier list almost this time, because we went over every god. It's always good, and then you guys can know everything about all these gods. Isn't that great? And hope you guys enjoyed. Like and subscribe if you did. Remember, dual tier list is just a guideline for ranked duel. You know, these gods may not perform how they're shown on the tier list. This is just what I think they're going to do with the current state of the game right now. Got any feedback on it? Let me know. And I'll see you guys later for more Smite. Deuces!